Thank you for joining this quick troubleshooting video. In this video, we are going to learn how to force users to use single sign-on in order to log into Salesforce. This can be done by using delegated authentication feature in Salesforce. Just to inform that we can have both SAML SSO and delegated authentication in one org. Please keep in mind that in order to follow these steps, you might need system admin permissions. First, we need to deploy my domain and configure the login policy to require login from my domain to true. Now, as part of second step in this process, we need to enable delegated authentication at the org level. This permission is shown under single sign-on settings. If you do not see this permission enabled, please log a case with Salesforce support in order to enable it. Once the permission is enabled, then we need to add a misconfigured endpoint URL or a dummy URL and force the callout to error out. This means when a user enters username and password to log in using login.salesforce.com or my domain URL, those details were directly sent to a web service to authenticate the user's identity. Since we have configured with a dummy URL for web service, the callout fails and the user will not be able to log in using login.salesforce.com or the my domain URL. I have added a misconfigured URL here and checked force logout to true. Now, the final step. We need to set a profile permission. Is single sign-on enabled to true for every profile which you wish to prevent from logging in using a username and password. We can also accomplish this with a permission set or at a profile level. This particular step is important, as you want to make sure you do not enable this profile permission for system administrators. We need at least one user profile to be able to log in via username and password in case the SAML IDP goes down. Now, I have created a permission set which has e-single sign-on enabled, and I am assigning this permission to a user and then test this behavior. Now, I have added this permission set to the user. Let's try logging in using login.salesforce.com. I'm adding the username and the password here. We see an error mentioning server is down. Let's try using my domain URL. This one should also error out. Adding the username and password here. We see the same error message. As I said, we would not be assigning this permission set to system admins since they need to log in just in case if SAML SSO is down for some reasons. This way, we can restrict users to log in only using SAML SSO. Thank you for watching, and we hope you found this helpful. If you have any questions, please visit the Salesforce help portal where you can find great resources including communities, documentation, trails, and you can also contact support anytime. Happy trailblazing!